It's June 27th, 2023, and I'm on my way to St Albans, Vermont for an action-packed day of railfanning. First up, CPKC train 928 rolling south at Spelman Road in Beekmantown. At Italy Yard in St. Albans, yard job 501 starts their day of switching by pulling an empty center beam up the Y to load some short rail pieces. I'm pretty sure this was to be used in maintenance of way work somewhere else on the railroad. National Weather Service, you said slight chance of showers, not pouring driving rain. If I had known it was gonna do this, I wouldn't have come. I don't mind some sprinkles. Okay, that's better. During the downpour, I checked out the small Amtrak station, which had some neat memorabilia and a vintage feel. At 9 o'clock sharp, the southbound Amtrak Vermonter pulls down to the station. Thank you.
I'm not sure. Stopping raining. Perfect.
After a quiet morning, I move north to Swanton for southbound CN train M324. A marker light Gevo and a former City Rail Gevo make for an interesting duo. The conductor drops off the train to be taxied into the yard by road.
We're gonna be here a while.
after dropping their train, the crew builds the outbound 323 before departing northbound for Montreal. Returning to North Elm Street, we find 501 back at work. By this time, Ryan from Weathered Rails has joined me for some afternoon action.
Thank you.
As 501 continues to switch, Train 500, the chip train, comes rolling north up the main with a great duo of Canadian Jeeps. Before leaving St. Albans, I took a peek at the shops, finding two of NECR's former Florida East Coast units in for servicing. My final shot of the day would be back in Swanton, where 500 shoves its train north before returning south light power.
Nice evening.
With 500 heading back to St. Albans, I headed for home. Check out Ryan's video linked in the description, subscribe, like the video, and I'll see you next time.